I'm gonna let you in on something. We love tech news so much that we even use technology to make this news show.
What is this voice?
Intel made a big deal last week about the fact that it was launching its Arc mobile GPUs, and, well, they weren't technically lying, but it turns out that the only market they actually launched in was South Korea, and in one laptop model, the Samsung Galaxy Book 2 Pro.
Good laptop.
I mean, I get it, you know, you thought Intel was launching Arc GPUs. You were confused. What an idiot. This was just a little launch with a small L.
Oh, yeah.
Intel tweeted the clarification in response to a user asking if they can, you know, buy one of those things that apparently launched last week, adding that laptops with Intel Arc will be available for purchase by the end of Q2, so late June. Accordingly, one of the only other models with Arc configurations, the Acer Swift X, has had its release delayed from the previously announced date of May 22nd. All I can say is, you better get those GPUs out to the rest of the world soon, Intel, because gamers don't take kindly to broken promises.
And they can be very intimidating.
They're dangerous, David is.
Epic Games has partnered with that famous maker of easily breakable toys, Lego, to build, pun intended, a special section of the metaverse just for kids. A plan that could end up with no horrible consequences whatsoever. The two companies haven't exactly fleshed out what this will look like, but they did confirm that they'd have three principles in mind: ensuring children's safety and well-being, protecting children's privacy, and profiting lots and lots off of the wallets that adults will be using to pay for this wholesome content. Sorry, no, number three, adult tools to give them control over the digital experience of their children. Those are all the things that you would expect them to say, but if Roblox set the bar for a children's game centered on building myriad virtual worlds, well, it shouldn't be too hard for Epic and Lego to exceed that. It just has to be not a scam based on exploiting young developers.
Oh, bam!
Boom!
Got him!
And in other partnership news, Google is the latest tech giant to announce that it is jumping on to the iFixit bandwagon. Now, I know bandwagoning has a negative connotation, but to be clear, we support this move.
It's a good bandwagon.
Google will provide / allow iFixit to sell genuine parts for all Pixel phones from the Pixel 2 onwards, and iFixit will also provide enhanced repair guides for said phones. So does this mean Pixel owners can finally repair those camera modules that have been straight up broken for years with no conceivable way to fix it other than to mail it to Google to fix themselves?
I certainly hope so. My freaking Pixel 3 has been broken for like a year and a half.
Well, you did it, Lewis. You did it. Just like,
Now it's time for Quick Bits, brought to you by Brilliant, the website and app that makes learning STEM accessible and fun. It's like if you made vegetables taste like donuts. It's a miracle of science. Brilliant is about active learning, so it's chock full of interactive visual problems to solve. Plus, there's no harsh grading, long lectures, or strict time limits, because you're here to have fun and learn, not impress the principal. Check out the new Everyday Math course and refresh your knowledge of foundational math topics you might not have touched since high school, or dive into any of the 60 other different courses. Brilliant is your oyster. Join today using our link down below, and the first 200 people will save 20% off a yearly subscription. That's brilliant.org/techlink. Get smart!
You gotta let your butt quacks cool on the countertop before you enjoy them.
Right.
And not so fast, they'll burn your mouth. Canada was jealous when other countries bullied tech giants into paying news publishers, so our government has introduced new legislation, Bill C-18, which will force platforms like Facebook or Twitter to pay news outlets every time a user posts a news link. Some similar bills in Australia and Europe were dropped after Google and Facebook made deals with news conglomerates to pay for including content in those companies' official news services. So hopefully Canada makes a similar deal. Yeah, that system works.
You just intimidate people.
Apple has restored the Smart Voting iOS app, sponsored by prominent critic of the Russian government, Alexei Navalny, after removing it last September in response to demands by Russian law enforcement. Google had restored the Android version days after removing it, but Apple only did so now once the coast was obviously clear. Is everyone else calling out Russia now?
Okay, we're all doing this?
Okay, all right, everyone else? Okay, we're good to go, green light.
We are so brave.
Courageous decision. SpaceX successfully launched their first all-private crew on a mission to dock with the International Space Station this morning. The crew consists of three businessmen who paid $55 million each for the privilege. and an astronaut escort who will presumably have to stop them from pestering the scientists working there with inane questions like, how do you poop up here? And is that the Earth?
Is that actually
Mars? Is it actually? Great minds. In other news about Elon, Tesla held a grand opening for its Gigafactory in Texas, where Elon Musk once again drove the Cybertruck on stage and promised that it would start shipping in just a couple of years. Wow. He also promised that a wider beta of the company's full self-driving tech will roll out this year, at which point the whole audience started nodding and saying, I've never heard him say that before. gee willikers, Elon, thank you. I love ya. And Facebook, undeterred by its Diem cryptocurrency project crashing out and burning, is apparently working on a different digital coin known internally as Zuckbucks. Because how are we supposed to get to a dystopian future where corporations have replaced national governments as the de facto societal authority? Unless we have Zuckbucks. I see this as progress. And we have progressed to the end of this video. Come back on Monday for more tech news, which, ironically, you'll have to use technology to access. See how that works? It's all connected.
Oh, dude. The vibe.
It's tech linked.
Ah!
Linus Bucks coming soon.